Today we are talking all about snow. Snow can be so pretty and fun and really kind of magical. But how does snow work? How does it actually form? I'm Adam Peterson and I'm from the Chicago area, and my students have always loved snow days. So I'm excited to take a closer look with you about how it actually works. Before we take a look at how snow forms, let's take a look at what snow actually is. Snow is actually tiny little ice crystals falling from the sky. Doesn't that sound amazing? Ice crystals falling from the sky. These little snow crystals start when water vapor sticks to a tiny speck of dust, dirt, or pollen inside a cloud. As that water vapor sticks to that tiny speck, it forms a teeny tiny ice ball. Then, more and more specks stick to the ice ball, which eventually forms the big six-sided crystal we know as a snowflake. As a snowflake grows, it gets heavier and heavier. And then gravity takes over, pulling it down from the clouds. Now, multiply this by millions and millions of snowflakes, and there you have it, it's snowing. Here are a few really fun facts about these snowflakes. First, a single snowflake can be made up by more than 200 crystals. That's impressive, right? Also, almost all snowflakes have six sides. So, we need water vapor in the air to get snow. But that's not the only thing we need for it to snow. We also need clouds, and we need a cold day. It has to be 32 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 0 degrees Celsius, or colder to snow. Snow is actually pretty important. It helps keep our planet at the right temperature. It can also be an important source of water for people, animals, and plants. So the next time you get the chance to see a snowfall, take a look up and admire those tiny little crystals. After all, they went to a lot of work to get to you.